Born on December 11th, 1959, Doug Furnas is the physical, cultural legend you may have never heard of. A pro wrestler and powerlifter, Furnas wrestled in the WWF, WCW, ECW, and the All Japan Pro Wrestling Circuit, while also setting multiple world records in the 270-pound weight class. Like any true physical culturalist, Furnas' skill set expanded beyond just one specialty. Although he is best known for his powerlifting and his pro wrestling accomplishments, Furnas excelled initially in high school and junior college football, even making it to the Denver Broncos training camp. It's also rumored that Doug was a competitive bull rider in his early years. From football, Doug transitioned into powerlifting, first in the 242-pound class, before bulking up to the 275-pound division. Known as one of the greatest squat technicians in powerlifting history, Furnas was the third man to total 2,400 pounds and the first man to do it at two separate meets. The first time he reached this feat was at the inaugural APF World Championships held in 1986 on Maui, Hawaii. In an old squat suit, he squatted 986 pounds. Wearing a loose bench shirt, he benched 600 pounds, and he pulled 814 in the deadlift. 6 months later, at the APF National Championships in Minnesota, he totaled 2,403 pounds. Before making the shift from powerlifting to pro wrestling, Furnas set 29 powerlifting world records. Like many wrestlers, Doug made his debut on the independent circuit before making it to the big show. He worked for a brief stint in the WCW as a member of Sting's Dudes with Attitudes in 1990, which feuded with Ric Flair's notorious Four Horsemen. As a tag team partner with Dan Crawford, he participated in what Wrestling Observer Newsletter called the Match of the Year in 1992. Later, Furnas wrestled in the WWF's Survivor Series in 1996. Alongside ring legends like Flyin' Brian Pillman and Rocky Johnson, he is often remembered as having one of the best drop kicks in pro wrestling. In retirement, Doug showed that his heart was as big as his powerlifting totals. He ran a group home for abused boys in San Diego. He also raised rodeo bulls on his family farm. Furnas would only train twice a week. On Sunday, he would bench and do close grip and wide grip variations. On Wednesday, he would squat and deadlift. Before a contest, Doug would complete a 14-week training phase, starting with 10 reps on the bench, then adding weight and dropping reps to sets of 8, 5, 3, and eventually 2. With the squat, he would never go over 5 reps, and he would often do sets of 5 or 3 reps. According to an interview with Furnas in 1988, he did no negatives or forced reps, and he did not deadlift frequently. In fact, when he did deadlift, it would often be after his squat. Nonetheless, he became one of the most prominent, important, and powerful lifters in the 20th century. For more of these old legends and the history of physical culture, click subscribe.